My name is Joseph Powell. I'm the head of the Garvan-Weizmann Center for Cellular Genomics, and I'm also the head of the Single Cell and Computational Genomics Lab. We use stem cells essentially as a way of modeling complex diseases. So complex diseases are diseases where there are a large number of genetic factors that contribute to an individual's risk. We all carry those genetic factors, and we ultimately do not know really how they act. We don't know how they act in different cell types, and we don't know how they act as cells develop from immature or pluripotent state through to a mature state. And so our kind of key questions that we're interested in is identifying those genetic variants and how they act at a cellular level across cell development time courses. So to do this in a human system would be extremely difficult because, you know, for obvious reasons, but we can really mimic and model the development of tissues and cell types using stem cells and stem cell technologies. There's been some really phenomenal breakthroughs in technology in the last few years of being able to generate genetic or genomic information for an individual cell, but then to do that for very large numbers of cells at the same time. And so the Garvan-Weizmann Center houses a wide variety of technology that allows us to isolate, curate, culture, differentiate stem cells, generate these genomic profiles on tens of thousands of stem cells and differentiated cells at the same time, take that digital readout and then feed it into supercomputers and allow analysts like myself and my team members to ask key critical questions with that type of data. In the average lifespan of an individual, we will suffer on average from 8 different diseases. These could be cardiovascular diseases, cancers, neurological conditions, autoimmune diseases. So one of the things that we're really motivated by is trying to ultimately solve and cure those diseases, although I think that's a grand statement, but really is to try to mitigate and reduce the disease severity within society. And using stem cells as a way to model this myriad of different tissues and different cell types and different organs and different diseases creates essentially a unified platform to be able to address a huge range of different diseases and critical problems in a really rapid and transformative manner. We're always looking out for, and I think as a community, wanting to engage with people who are enthusiastic and passionate about not only the intellectual challenges, but also the application of what they can achieve with research and through thinking deeply about a problem and working to solve that problem.
My name is Drew Neavin. I'm in Joseph Powell's lab, and we're a single cell and computational genomics lab. And we're really interested in how genetics interfaces with complex disease and trying to understand how genetics relates to health and disease. So we have tons of cells that make up our entire human body, right? And so even if we take cells from, say, the blood, there's all sorts of different types of cells in the blood, and that's true of the entire human body. And so trying to see what each individual cell does is really important for us to understand how different biological processes work. And so single cell really allows us to look at each individual cell, and we can then really piece out the entire blood or an organ system into each of the individual cells that make it up. Using single cell technologies with stem cell technologies really provides a really interesting interface where we can ask interesting questions about development and disease and model both of those systems and try and understand them a lot better.
Probably one of the most rewarding areas of research for me since starting a lab is building strong collaborations with molecular stem cell labs. And that's allowed us to address questions that would ordinarily be impossible for us to consider. And similarly for those labs, has armed those with the mathematical and computational tools to be able to drive our research forward. With colleagues that I've been working with for 5, 6, 7, 8 years now, people like Elise Peeby and Alex Hewitt and Neavin Palpent, we have built shared research programs where we've been working on the same questions for years together with shared resources and have a deep understanding of each other's capabilities and what we bring to the table and where we can essentially leverage our our different expertise to address something that would ordinarily be impossible.